Good morning and welcome to Wednesday morning prayer. And it's good to welcome our dear sister Jan on both channels. And it's sister Suzanne. Welcome at this unearthly hour. Bless you. And good morning, sister Barbara from sunny Sweden. And good morning, dear sister Pam from sunny South Wales. And good morning, dear sister Karina from sunny Sweden. And good morning, dear sister Sue from sunny Blackpool. Because it must be sunny in Blackpool because it's a beautiful morning here at last in Cumbria. A day for being in the garden. So this morning, excuse me, I dedicate my prayers for divine protection against a COVID spike here and around the world. We have got a spike in several places now in England, but we pray for our dear brother Michael in Perth, Australia, where they've now closed the borders between Victoria and Australia. We pray for all God's children whose lives have been impacted or affected by COVID. And we pray that the children of God will take responsibility for their own actions to protect themselves and to protect others, and to consider those working on the front line, our doctors and nurses and care workers and paramedics, and many of whom are exhausted, and quite a few have had mental health breakdowns from the pressure and the stress. So we ask our loving God to bless each and every one of us. But I also pray for you, for your requests. Amen. And now, as customary every morning, we take a little trip over across the sea to beautiful Waterford, to St. Mary's Abbey. Good morning, Mary, who's joined us also for morning prayer. And our prayer this morning is from the Little Book of Celtic Prayers. And interestingly, when I asked upstairs for guidance, I was just told to open the book at random. And the section I got comes under for forgiveness. Just excuse me, I'm a tad thirsty. It's thirsty work doing God's work, isn't it? With regret, with unfilled dreams, we come to you. With shattered hopes, we come to you. With frustrated endeavors, we come to you. With unconfessed sins, we come to you. With many regrets, we come to you. With missed opportunities, we come to you. For you alone make all things new. Lord Jesus, Lamb of God, the Good Shepherd, have mercy on us. When we stray from you and gently lead us back to yourself. Amen. That's a lovely prayer to begin morning prayer. And our hymn, again, chosen by the Holy Spirit. It's from Hymns for Living, and it's hymn number 178, A Shelter from the Vast, from Sidney Royce Lysach, born in 1856. A shelter from the vast we win in homely hearts and make therein the glow of light, the sound of mirth that bind all children of the earth in fellowship. And when the rain beats loud upon the window pane, the shadows of the firelight fall across the floor and on the wall. We know that countless heart lights burn in darkened places and discern, inwoven with the troubled plan of worlds and ways unknown to man. The shelter at the heart of life, the refuge beyond the doubt and strife, the rest for every soul outcast, the homely hidden in the vast. Amid the boundless and unknown, we call some darkened spot our own. Though all without is unexplored, uncharted lands and seas and world, we doubt not that whatever fate may lie beyond us soon or late, however far afield we roam, the unknown way will lead us home. That is a lovely hymn, and I think it's my first time ever reading it. Now we come to our first reflection for today from the late Father Henry J.M. Nouwen. And it's an interesting reflection because it's based on what we're looking for is already here. So let's read what he has to say. To start seeing that the many events of our day, week, or year are not in the way of our search for a full life, but are rather the way to it is a real experience of conviction. We discover that cleaning and cooking, writing letters and doing professional work, visiting people and caring for others are not a series of random events that prevent us from realizing our deepest self. These natural daily activities contain within them some transforming power that changes how we live. We make it in passage from time lived as Chronos to time lived as Kairos. Kairos is a Greek word meaning the opportunity. It is the right time, the real moment, the chance of our lives. When our time becomes Kairos, it frees us and opens us to endless new possibilities. Living Kairos offers us an opportunity for a profound change of heart. Amen. And from our little book, In God's Presence by Brigitte Marie, we read for today one word for reflection, and the word is confidence. And it's underpinned from the readings of 1 John chapter 3, verses 19 to 20. The fact that God knows everything and you are his child should give you confidence. Confidence in knowing that he hides nothing from his children. Avail yourself to the Lord and he will lift you up. Be willing and obedient, and you shall receive every great thing that God has ordained for your life. Allow your life to glorify God like never before. Don't dwell on your past. God will forgive and forget everything you've done that is not like him. From this day forward, make a commitment to stay disciplined and obedient in what he has called you to do. You will then begin to see God's plan for your life unfold. Walk in the purpose that God has for you. That reading just sings to my soul, because I get so much correspondence from seekers of light, seekers of truth, trying to discern God's will. And the root cause of not discerning or hearing God's voice is because so many are locked in fear. So many lives are almost destroyed by negativity, by worry, by fear, feelings of low self-worth, and where many are afraid to be still, afraid that God may punish them for not listening, and where many who were brought up, especially cradle Catholics like myself, carry so much guilt. My poor mom, when she was dying 5 to 6 years ago, I wasn't there because I'm enclosed. But my sister Rosemary told me that she had the most horrible death. And that really upset me. She was screaming out, "Don't let me go. Don't, please don't let me go." And I discovered that a lot of it was fear. She was brought up with a mindset that God will punish you for whatever you do. And many Catholics who were brought up in that old school, as I was, even in the monastery, where you were a number, not a person. She was so afraid of dying that she cried out and had a miserable death. And today, many of God's beloved children who walk the path, so many carry so much baggage. And one of the greatest pieces of baggage they carry with them is guilt. 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 So if you are one of those who've joined us, why not name your guilt and give it to the Lord? Because he's already forgiven you. But in Catholic rituals, the emphasis always focused on hell, punishment, fear, and that God is a vindictive God. It's changed, yes. The Catholic Church has changed a lot since then, but people of my generation still carry a lot of baggage of unworthiness. They're not good enough. They've got to prove themselves to God to win God's favor. That's heresy. That's blasphemous. God died out of love. The Son of God died out of love to set you and me free. But it's hard to be free when someone has hurt you, really hurt you, where they've raped you or abused you. But Christ gives us the strength to forgive. And in that moment of forgiveness, we are given the beautiful feeling and inner knowing of confidence that we can trust God because he loves us. Let us be still. And let us come to our little book of wisdom from His Holiness the Dalai Lama. Work for the welfare of all. With a pure heart, you can carry on any work, and your profession becomes a real instrument to help the human community. And the next reflection is what I call a real piece of jewelry, a nugget, a pearl of great price. Don't be seduced by worldly values. Materialism does not foster the growth of morals, compassion, and humility. And I can add to that, it alienates the soul from a loving God. I've seen it, as I'm sure you have too. Let us come now. I've talked enough. I'm guided by the Spirit now, not to play the Benedictus, the Canticle of Zechariah, but I'm guided to play this for you. Just listen to the words, and hopefully they'll ignite within your soul the flame of divine love. It's the St. Teresa's Prayer by John Michael Talbot.
Christ has no body now but yours. No hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes to which he looks. compassion on this world. Yours are the feet with which he wants to do good. Yours are the hands with which he blesses all the world. Yours are the hands, yours are the feet, yours are the eyes, you are his body. Christ has no body now but yours. No hands, no feet on earth but yours. Yours are the eyes through which he looks, compassion on this world. Christ has no body now on earth but yours.
And I'm guided now first to go into silence and reflect on those words. Just be still and know that our God is here, that Christ is present, as are all the angels and archangels of the Lord God, with all of the saints, with Francis and Claire, with Padre Pio, with little Therese of Lisieux, with Therese of Avila, and Therese of Calcutta, and all the great ascended masters, and all our loved ones in spirit, including our pets, are all with us, watching over us, comforting us, strengthening us. Just be still now. And just relax as I ask the Holy Spirit to guide all our hearts so that we have no fear, no unforgiveness, no shame, no pain. Let us come as that beautiful child of God. God created you and me as a whole and perfect child of God. We incarnated on this earth plane as a whole and perfect child of God. We came from six-dimensional energy into a dense energy, a lower frequency, possibly third-dimensional energy, where many of us built brick walls around our heart to protect us from more hurt, from deceit, from abuse, from anger. But now, let us ask Christ to take our hand, the hand of our spirit, and remove this brick wall from our heart so that we can feel again, love again, be strong again, and fall in love with our first love, the Christ, the Son of God, the Cosmic Christ. Lord Sananda Jesus, incarnated as the Son of God, to bring to you and me hope and release from all guilt and all fear and all unforgiveness. But our mind, our ego, that is very much controlled by other negative emotions and feelings, by dark energies and entities, and by Satan or the Antichrist, blocks us every step of our spiritual advancement. But we have the power within our being to command it to go to the light in Jesus' name. Lord Jesus, come to each one of us now. You have prepared us this morning through the beautiful reflections and the videos to now say, come Lord, come into my life, come into my heart, and empower me experience a new reawakening to who I was before God, a spirit of the purest light and love. Lord, release from my being all deterrence, all negativity from my life, and allow me be an open receptacle for you to fall in love with me again. Now feel the arms and the gentle touch of Christ hold you. And now let him speak to you privately, person to person, soul to soul. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I adore you. There is no other God but you, Lord. You are my life. You are my future. You are the way, Lord. Show me your way. Show me your way. Breathe in the breath of your God, and in your out breath, release to Christ whatever may be troubling you, whatever you are hurting. Name it, bless it, and give it to Christ. But leave it there, and now thank him, because he's heard your prayer. He has granted your request. Now let us celebrate. Let us celebrate. Let us celebrate his love for us. And he places his hand over our heart. Hearts that have been battered and broken and bruised. Hearts that have been deceived and wronged. Hearts that have witnessed cruelty and experienced cruelty. Now feel the gentle touch of his selfless love flow through your heart, empowering you now to say, "Here I am, Lord. I come home to your love. But show me, Lord, how may I serve you? And give me the courage, Lord, to serve you with all my heart, and not to look back on the past, but to stay focused in the present and to celebrate your joy, your peace, and your love. Lord, give me the strength to distance myself from the dramas of this world, from the media, and from all negativity, and from persons whose only agenda is to destroy our confidence. Protect us with your blood, Lord. Protect us with your spirit. Breathe on me, O breath of God. Fill me with life anew, that I might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. I pray for each one of us here, and for the whole family of God, where many are suffering, and where many are being used as modern day slaves in sweatshops, producing cheap clothing for us. For the Rohingya refugees have almost been exterminated. For the children of God held in China's prisons, the 51 different ethnic beliefs all being punished and reprogrammed. And the cruelty that is dished out to the children of God, the lack of respect that we have for ourselves and for others. We pray today that every child of God, created in the image and likeness of God, regardless of their color, creed, belief, or gender orientation or disability, are welcomed and loved as a unique creation, a people set apart to sing God's praise. You and I are here as God's prayer partners for peace and for the healing of this sacred world, this beautiful sacred earth that mankind is destroying, and the animal kingdom that is being destroyed through greed. Lord, give each one of us the inner strength to rise up and be your light shining in those dark places, and that we spend our time grounded and centered as your prayer partner. For unity and peace, Lord, we pray, and for all who've asked our prayer. Let us be still now. Let us come in peace. And now for the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father who is in heaven, we are thy own. most holy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, your will be done on earth, O Lord. Your will be done on earth, O Lord. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our sins as we forgive. Your kingdom come, your will be done, your will be done on earth, O Lord. Your will be done on earth, O Lord. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Yours is the kingdom, the power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Forever and ever. Amen.
That was an amazing recording arranged by Michael Brooks here in the UK, sung by the parish of Herne Hill choir and musicians. It was a virtual performance where they couldn't meet because of lockdown, so they did this amazing recording from their own homes. Isn't it amazing what we have at our disposal today? Right, let's conclude with the prayer and final blessing.
Almighty and ever-living God, strengthen our faith, our hope, and our love. May we do with loving hearts what you ask of us, and come to share the life you promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face shine on you and bring you peace.
Amen.
Let us
thank the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And now, a closing prayer, but a video. My Peace by the Maranatha Sinners. I know it's one of Brother Barry's favorites. I'd like to dedicate it for dear Barry, who's struggling with breathlessness because his pacemaker isn't, his new pacemaker isn't working as effectively as it should. So we pray for our dear Brother Barry and for all who are still in lockdown, who are vulnerable, classed as vulnerable like myself. So here's my peace, my gift to you, to thank you for letting me praise God with you. Amen.
Peace to know, peace to
Joined by Brother Sid. You could see his sore ear. So we come to blow out this light, a light that symbolizes the divine already within you. Reclaim your divinity today by allowing the Spirit of God speak to your heart, that you are a good person, that you are a child of the light, and that your life matters to God. Be strong and unite in a spirit of thanksgiving to God for all the many blessings we receive. Let us stay centered and focused and not give in to negativity. Amen. Go in peace to love and to serve a loving God who has many names and none. Namaste, Shalom, Inshallah, Pax et Bonum, OmShanti, Solo di Caritas, Salam Alaikum, and may the peace and the love and the joy of our God empower you now. Go out into the world and let God's light shine through you in your smile. And please keep our dear brother Idrissa in your prayer, because I'm praying for a miracle this week that he will be released from this awful, unfair incarceration, all because he wants to represent five villages, keep their land. So keep dear brother Idrissa in your prayer. Amen. Have a wonderful day, dear friends. God bless you. God bless you. And take care. And to my dear friends on YouTube, dear Sister Jan, a loyal and faithful troubadour to the Lord. Ah, Sister Claire is with us. Bless you, Claire. And dear Sister Sue, who's got a new name, James Martin. Well, that was her dear son, James, who died. And who else? Well, whoever watches this, you're more than welcome. Have a lovely day.